There's some deer out in my field over there, in my house here. I'm getting focused now.
And the whole debt crisis that we face, and still win. And yet he did. He did. The Obama campaign did very many things that were right. Romney, you could point to a couple things with Romney. One, he may not have been a candidate for 2012, given his corporate turnaround background and so on. And secondly, he did not get something that Republicans have counted on now in presidential races, and that's the white working class vote. And in states like Ohio, the ads attacking Romney as a corporate raider and buccaneer and so on that were on for many, many months in the spring and summer.
Grab this up right away. I didn't have time to set the tripod.
The white working class vote did not turn out for Mitt Romney in the numbers he needed.
You had a piece in
the wrong area, the wrong side of the field there.
Is the headline. You note in that article that the Obama campaign exposed the myth of the unenthusiastic Democratic voter. Explain that.
Don't start barking on it. I thought it was a car coming on the road over here.
That was the idea.
November 9, 2012, 7:50 a.m. Central Time.
And they were not feeling enthusiastic about the campaign, and it was the conservatives and Republicans
who were
ready to go. And so the notion was, you got this surge.
They might cross the road over there if I get this.
Democratic turnout. Well, there was a pretty good turnout of Republican voters, but there was a surge of Democratic voters. It was amazing how well Obama did
in the coalition
election in 2008. And so, Democratic voters was going to keep them from voting. It just didn't happen. It turned out to be a myth. And of course, whether you're an enthusiastic voter or an unenthusiastic voter, you only get one vote.
Was on the Republican side, was there an overconfidence born from how well Republicans did in the midterm election in 2010?
Well, I wouldn't call it overconfidence, but there was certainly an
okay from my house here
that Republicans really had a good chance.
It's about
President Obama.
500 feet, 500, 600 feet.
It became harder to expect as we got really deeper into the campaign, particularly this fall, but. Then it was boosted again by Romney's performance.
There's two of them over there. I thought there were three, like I said. I think they're going to cross the road here eventually.
There was ever overconfidence that that was going to happen.
We're talking to Fred Barnes, editor of the Weekly Standard. You can join in on the conversation with questions and comments. The phone numbers are there on the screen for you to start calling in now. And as you're doing that, Mr. Barnes, I want to take you to this editorial in the
I bought the tripod so I could put it on there and it won't be so jittery like this.
Lopsided loss reveals the heart of the Republican dilemma, the party's lack of appeal to women, minorities, and the young. Mm-hmm. Take each part of those.
It's like in a movie I'd be expecting to sit here and be filming something like this, all of a sudden the thing just dropped.
Call that a lopsided loss, for one thing. It was a pretty close election. I think Romney lost by, 2.5 million votes. That's not a squeaker for Obama, but it's not a lopsided loss.
Eat that Monsanto corn over there.
There are two groups that are very
that's what them fields were, with Monsanto corn.
And the obvious one is Hispanics. I mean,
keep zooming out so I can keep both of them in.
And when you go from getting 44%
in the frame.
Hispanic vote in 2008, which George W. Bush did, to 31%, John McCain got in 2008 to 27% that Romney got. That's a bad situation for Republicans when you have the group that is growing.
My wife saw something the other day. Across the road and went over into the trees. I'll zoom out here and show you the trees she was talking about. I can't really see them here. They're off in the distance right over here. I have to do it from out front.
Obama did not do well among white women, for instance. It's the number for women is a little distorted because so many are Hispanic women and African-American women who may not be voting, may be voting for the Democrat for other reasons.
Exit polls showing female voters went 55% to 44%.
There's like a little ravine down there.
Permanent gender gap.
Ditch.
In every election.
Some people, it's like a ditch, basically.
Midterm elections.
Not real deep, but...
came out even, but
that's where they're, you can even see the crevice there, that whole, that line basically.
You have to think about doing better, but I think you do better when you have better candidates.
It's deeper in certain areas. Okay, I'll get ready to stop recording that, because they're just over there pillaging for food, evidently.
Get older, they become,
it's 40-something degrees outside, so... We had a frost yesterday. Last night it didn't get as cold as they were saying, but it's supposed to get 28 degrees in a couple days outside. Might see some more out this way. But, as you can see, that's the view out here.
Here's another place, though, John, that I think where Republicans really need to do better.
That house over there, that trailer over there is about half a mile. Just under half a mile, about away from us.
Did extremely well in the suburbs. Now, I live in the suburbs.
Going down the road out in front here.
Potomac River from Washington. I live in
Alexandria. Okay, no, that looks like they're going to make a dash for it.
Next door, those are inner suburbs.
Yeah, they're going to cross the road down there.
Become very Democratic. The Republicans not going to win those. I think in Alexandria,
yep.
Obama got 70%.
They're in the road crossing.
And 67% in Arlington. But then when you get farther out, that's been the Republican heartland.
Don't have a lot of traffic on this road. That's how people get the cars get their front ends messed up, killing the deer, being out in the road like that. We had a few of them jump out by us going the other way. Oh, this is a crappy camera. It's not my other one. The other one I loved.
In Loudoun County.
JVC.
20, 25 miles outside of Washington, D.C.
This is Samsung, which is buying everything, so deal with it. It's like you take the shit they give you or you don't take anything at all, so gotta deal with this kind of crap. It almost had an 80-time focus where I could go up so close on planes and everything else. Couldn't read everything, but it was better than this. I could zoom in on those deer like...
The term turnout.
This gas tank right here, I can zoom in just like that on the deer all the way over there. Get off and lost them. Oh, there they go.
Does that go away when Obama leaves office?
Well, Republicans can hope so, but I'm sure the Democratic Party and its, particularly its strategists have figured out that, we have to repeat this. You know, we've seen what the Obama campaign can do, and we're going
to
do it again.
They're running off in the field. They're going to go over to the trees. The trees back there. The river is up on the other side. Right where that tree line is over there is the river. The middle fork.
I want to kick you to a clip of Richard Viguerie, a conservative writer, talking about what needs to happen with the Republican Party now.
Oh, that's the deer.